Alright guys, so I've been wanting to do this project, for a while. I've been really excited to finally work on my first official canvas, and I know that some people have been excited to see what comes of this wonderful project. So this is actually a project requested of me by my health coach. She wanted me to do a journal page. I decided because I wanted to start getting into canvases and seeing how much I liked them, and I thought that they'd be really fun that I wanted to do more of a mixed media style canvas instead of a journal page. So we are going to go ahead and start. So these are the papers I chose to start out with, and I forgot my paint brushes elsewhere, so I'm gonna have to go get the rest of them later and finish out this video, but that doesn't mean we can't start. So I got this golden absorbent ground. This will only be the second time I've used it. And keep in mind, I've never done this before. If this is your first time and you're joining along, kudos to you, and I can't wait to see what you guys make. Tag me on Instagram. I would love to see it. Of course, we got this. I got a thin canvas. I got these at Walmart. It was like a pack of three for pretty cheap. I got this Prima paper pack, and I fell in love with it. I found it at Tuesday morning, and I thought it would just be magnificent. So, I know that supposedly, the rumor is, now that I can't get the bottle open, that you just put this on your canvas to prep it. But before we go doing all that, I know you can also use that to mount some of your pages. So, I just want to pick a few. Oh, I love that one. I really like this one too. I like both sides of that. Okay, so we have just a few in this one. Oh, I like that one. These are all just so pretty, guys. How do we decide? Well, I like how these ones have a couple of different options. And this one kind of has a square. So it's got, looks like magazine article here, or a newspaper article, and then some sheet music. Okay, I really like this one too. So I think I'll go with these two. All right. So we went ahead with this one, that one, and this set right here. Now, I obviously don't want to cover the whole canvas. I just want to do it in parts and pieces. So I'm just going to have a little bit of fun with this and start tearing up some pieces. I think it'll be fun. And of course, you know, whatever's left, I can put in my scrap box. Okay. I kind of like how that has both of them, but I just don't think it's going to match what I'm going for. I like the bee, but I feel like I'm more of a butterfly fan. So I'm going to tear him out in a circle. I don't know, maybe we'll do the butterfly 3D or something. And we got a little bumblebee on there also. And I'm going to tear off some of this excess paper. And this is kind of what I'm going for too. It's just this ruggedy, tore up look. I kind of like it with this shabby chic paper. What, Lexi? You crawling around under the desk. Okay. I like both of these. So, yeah, I have decided. I think I want I like this though. Ah, here we go. I don't have my cutting board, but I want to whack off a piece of that. There we go. What are we doing? I don't know. What if we go like this? Yeah. I kind of like that. Okay, I'm not 100% sure, but I think it's what I want. So I want to tear this off. Who knows, we may not even really need the other paints. All right. Now let's go to town with some of this absorbent ground. Here we are. I'm just going to go ahead and coat it in there really good. Now, I remember when I was younger, even like coloring with coloring books with my mom and my brother, that one of the first things we learned was, and I mean officially learned, they handed us crayons and all that other stuff, but I was about 6 years old. The first thing I officially learned was if you wanted your strokes to look unison with your crayons, you tried to color all in the same direction. Now, of course, when you're 6 years old and you just want to cover, you're like, I don't care. But as you get older, you're like, oh, well, it would look nicer. And I want my colorings to look pretty like my mom's and my brother's. So, of course, we worked on it more, and I think by the time we were 7, our coloring actually looked pretty darn amazing. Of course, we had a couple of really amazing artisans in our family. One of the artisans in our family, immaculate, amazing portraits. I would love to be able to draw the way that he drew. It was just downright phenomenal. All right. And I do like this white space. It may not stay though, so we shall see what happens. Now you guys are probably like, no, 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 you're supposed to use that other stuff. Well, I'm learning. So if it comes off, it comes off. I'll re-glue something else. I'm just gonna brush up the edges, make it look faded into the canvas. I think that'll be really pretty. Looks like we need more under here. There we go. And see, we're learning. So for those of you who've never done a canvas together, if this is your first time, we all get to learn together. I'm just kind of like doing a little bit of a dry brush technique. Now that I remember from painting ceramics with my mom. And you just get as little paint as possible or whatever, you know, product you're working with. And just kind of dry brush it to the edges and smooth it out. So you still can see what's underneath, but you still have a little bit of whatever, you know, color you're working with going on within your project as well. All right, now it's time to get this guy on here. There. And I'm just going to come in with a razor knife when I'm finished and slice that off. So no need to worry. That will be taken care of. We want that corner to be covered. And I don't want this to go down too far onto the other one. So I'm going to go ahead and put some of my product directly onto my paper. And then that way I can play with the white and not have to worry about too much of it, the product ending up on my surface and having to figure out how in the world to fix it. See, kind of like that. There we go. Perfect. That, and I have it exactly where I want it. So. And if I want to add a little bit more in other places, I can just go back in and add it in. There we are. I'm really enjoying this. I think this is so much fun. I never did too much with painting for a while, and I kind of got back into it about, I think, a year or two ago when I went up to Colorado to visit some family. One of the siblings was getting married. Keep in mind, this sibling is from my birth family. I have 7 of them, and I actually have another one getting married this next year. Yeah, there's a lot of us, but she, for her bridesmaid's party, she did this art. She had like an art bar for the bridesmaid's party. And oh my God, was that not so much fun? So at the art bar, you could get wine if you wanted. And then from there, you know, you go over and do whatever project you were working on. And ours was this beautiful tulip garden. And I think I did show off the canvas to you guys once before. If not, then I'll try and remember to show it to you guys at the end of this if you haven't seen it. So everyone got a canvas and they all laid them together and they drew a bunch of tulip vines. And, you know, they painted them in their own color. So some of the blues for the sky differed and the vines differed between everybody. But she said, all right, I want some of your vines from each of your canvases to go onto other people's canvases. So we were like, okay, that'll be fun. And we went ahead and we did that. So after that, she's like, all right, well, now I'm going to teach you how to paint the tulip heads. And some of our vines that went onto other people's canvases, we painted the tulip heads onto the other canvases as well as our own. So separate, it was a little tulip like bed, but if you put all the photos together, they interlinked and they were a tulip garden, and it was just magnificent. Well, halfway through painting them, I'm like, I want a little ladybug on mine, so I paint a little ladybug. Well, I guess a lot of the girls there weren't as seasonally artistic as most, or as some, I should say, and they're like, oh my God, that's an adorable ladybug. So they had me paint a ladybug on theirs as well. And to this day, I still have obviously I do, because that was my first official baby sister. She was the first one that I found out after being adopted, and now I have that photo, and it is one of the coolest things I have from spending time with her. So I think that art bar experience was so much fun. And now, of course, I really want to get back into the painting because I really enjoy it. All right, I'm going to let this dry. This is still kind of like a concept piece. And I got a journal prompt on how I'm going to make it. So I got to go back and look at that journal prompt, and which is on my phone. And I'm currently filming for my phone. And I will be back to you in a moment. So I feel really silly. I'm sure you guys noticed I didn't have my audio hooked up. You can still hear me, obviously. It just didn't sound as crystal clear. So I went on to my Etsy page and I picked like the first 4. So I didn't dive that deep into them because I didn't want to spend too much time digging through all of them, because there's over 99 5-star reviews. Thank you so much for all of the love. I was told to do a journal prompt for something that inspired me to keep going, and all of your guys' wonderful reviews. Sometimes I just get on there and I gotta look at them, and that really keeps me going and keeps me working towards making all of these wonderful, magnificent journals. So I decided to print some of them off, and I'm going to be incorporating them into this canvas. Now, if you recognize yours, please leave a comment below. I would love to hear from you. It's pretty exciting to be able to take all these and go ahead and post them on this little canvas that will be hung in the office for me to come in and see every day and inspire me to keep going. So these will be really fun to work with. All right, now we're going to move these off to the side. And I didn't, like, I printed off, I think, 4 or 5 different pages. And I went through all those and I didn't pick the simple 5-star ones, obviously. If there was no comment, I didn't pick that one. I picked the really in-depth, thoughtful ones to be able to post up on this board. The more simple ones, because I wanted to add all the ones where, you know, someone put a lot of thought into them, because I just felt like, obviously, it was really, really nice and heartfelt. So it'll be really exciting to add these in to the wonderful board here. This one, I think, is from MJ. Actually, quite a few of these are from MJ. She has purchased quite a few of my things, and so that kind of gave me an idea for something I'm gonna do, but that will also be a surprise. So my little Lexi, she's sneaking. She's been being silly today. All right, we have, now I forgot my smaller paint brushes. I don't have access to them right now, but I still have this big one, and I think I have, no, maybe not. That's all right. We're just going to do overall, like, light brushing with the paints. We aren't going to do too much detail work. So this is the first time I'll be working with this set. I do have a smaller acrylic set that I've used quite a bit. I also left that with the other paint set because I was using it. And be careful, obviously, with a razor knife. You don't want to cut your paints open. That would be terrible. All right. I like this box set, too. It looks really nice. I kind of wish, instead of sliding into the sleeve, that it just had a lid. That would be really, really great for, let's see, Royal Land Nickel Essentials is this paint. And I think this is the same type of paint that I use with my smaller kit as well. And if it is, then this is some really great paint. I actually, when I first bought it, I fully intended on, I love that color. I fully intended on painting on little rocks that I had that were just so pretty. And they came out wonderful. I still got them floating around here somewhere, and I'll have to dig them out one day and show them to you guys. Let's see. I like the magenta, but I don't want to use too much of it because I'm not a big pink person. Although I'm slowly moving in that direction. I like the purple. Now, I don't think I want a vintagey yellow. Yeah. I feel it. Well, it could be all right. Let's see about a. I'm not feeling it, guys. I'm really not. How about. Still feel like it's too bright. I don't want to go with orange either. But instead of this brighter magenta, yeah, that. I think that one looks much better. And. Yeah, you know what? I'm just going to stick to these three colors. I'm going to keep it simple. And of course, my favorite color, I kind of want to start with that one. Now, this is obviously a little bit darker than my favorite color, but that's okay. I didn't really put too much of this primer all over the rest of the canvas. So we'll see how this looks without priming the whole canvas.
You know, I haven't done this in so long. We'll just use this box. That's okay. We'll just put a little bit on the box. I need to get a palette. When we were kids, we would use plates. Okay. So now I'm just going to smooth the paint out. Ooh, I love that color. Let's just go in there and just start going to work. Oh, yes. And of course, you know, right where we have some of our more problem areas, we'll stick a review over it. Is that terrible? That's terrible, isn't it? I really want to follow some of these, though. And I think I'm gonna stick with some of this white space and leave some of this white space here. Yes, and this is a form of dry brushing. I do know that. That is one technique I definitely know very well. I feel like this is my favorite color, so I want to add it some throughout most of the canvas because I love this color so much. And I'm gonna pick up the edge of the canvas so I don't. Oh yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and fold these around the back. I'm not even gonna cut them. I think it'll just, yeah, it finishes it out nicely. I think I like that. Right, we gotta smooth this out. Get some good color play going on here. I'm just gonna. Yeah, give it that just weathered look, you know, just play with it. This is experimenting. Why not, right? Oh, I love. And then I can come back in with the white and lighten it up some. Because, you know, I do feel like it's a little too dark, and that is okay. We can always play with the coloring. All right. Oh my. Think this is going to be very pretty. Maybe a little bit right here. Just kind of outline that a little. And I think a little bit along some of these, not too much, just a little, because these are going to get folded around. All right. Let's get a little bit of texture going on in this corner. Right. Now, I don't know how this is going to mix with this other color. So I'm just gonna see what it looks like. If I like it or if I have to go wash out my brush. And these are acrylics. Oh my, I love the mix we got going on here. Yes, that's very beautiful. I love like the airy effect that we have going on here. Need some clips for that. So I forgot these clip my clips, my little binder clips, but that's okay. Right, I'm going to take some of my trusty dust, not very dusty. It's not dusty at all, actually. I use it so much. Gluten, my Fabri-Tac 3-in-1, whichever you choose. This is just the first one I grabbed. I usually prefer 3-in-1. It's pretty much cheaper, and obviously for paper crafts, you know, I don't need the Fabri-Tac part. Alright. So I did forget my binder clips, but I do have these Giganto paper clips. That will work just as good. We just can't paint in this little area, obviously, until it dries a little. And that is perfectly okay. Oh, we got a little dab on, which is perfect. All right. There we go. Just get some paper clips in there to hold everything in place while we wait for it to dry. Yes, I think I'm gonna love it. I actually kind of like the paper clips with this, and the gold matches beautifully. I think that might be a fun idea. You know, since this kind of is like a little business themed, you know, maybe have a little, that'd be cute. I do want to have this raised, and I do have little foam doodads to do that with. All right, let's do some more purple here. I do want to play with a bit more of the purple. What, you little bit? She's over here being a turd. And we're just going to, you know, lightly play with it. Nothing crazy. Smooth that out some so we can get some dry brushing going on in here. Oh yes, I love that coloring. Woohoo! So pretty. So, I want to know who on here has worked with canvases. Oops, I just painted my cat. Who's worked with canvases? Tell me about it. Tell me about your first canvas. I would really seriously like to know. Even if it was a complete tragedy, I feel like, you know, even though it seems like it's pretty, I feel like, I don't know. I'm a little worried. Because, you know, this is my first official canvas. I do not see, I think I'm just going to do some touches of the pink. You know, not too much, but just a tad bit to give it a little bit of color pop and maybe blend some of this. But I'm going to mix it in with the purples. Just a little bit with the purple. Not too much. Oh, looks like we may not have a choice. All right, let's see what we can come up with this purple. Oh my. Well, I actually do not regret adding the, wow, it came out very pretty. And, you know, it's been a while since I've worked with the brush, so I know I need some work on my blending technique. There's nothing wrong with that. Get some of that pink and maybe some of these corners. I don't want too much of it, though, like I was saying. I just want enough to be like, hey, yeah, it's there, but it's not taking over, you know? Just to give it some character. I feel like that corner needs a little bit. I want some actual pink in that corner. There we go. Perfect. Now, of course, we still have some of the white space giving us a bit of clarity, I guess we could say. Just a little bit of clarity, hopefully, for the future and some beautiful projects. Now, I do feel like I want to blend these out. I really do. So I'm going to go wash this brush really quick. And it usually doesn't take too long to dry because I live in Arizona. All right, I'll be back. Alrighty. Now that we got all that going, we got a clean brush. Well, mostly clean. And glued down side here. So I'm going to go in with my absorbent ground here. Yeah, absorbent ground. Blah, blah, blah. You know what? I just realized I probably should have used the heavy gel mat. It's supposed to draw, move out your colors. So let's, we can keep playing with this if we want to, I guess. Oh my lord. I'm just going to do this. I am, oh wow. Yes, I'm loving this. Now I feel I should have. Oh wow, it's definitely making these colors beautiful. Oh my. This is what I was going for. I think it's just beautiful. You know, not too much, but just enough. Just that perfect bit. I love it. Oh my. What are you doing over there, Fluff? What are you doing? He's over in his little doggy bed. You know, doing the usual, keeping mom company while she's doing her crazy shenanigans. Huh, Fluff? Your crazy shenanigans, right, Ma? Talking to yourself. You're supposed to be talking to me. I know. There we go. Perfect. I want to blend that in. There we go. Oh, my. Oh, I'm loving it. Excuse me. Oh, my. It's funny when it does exactly what you want it to, and you didn't even, like, especially if you don't even know how to do it, you're like, oh, I'm just, you know, I'm exploring. I'm just playing. So pretty. See, get a little bit here. Oh my goodness. Now, of course, we still have some of the darker texture going on, but it's lightened it up exactly where I want it to be. And I feel like if I actually did some of the gel matte, that it would just draw everything together perfectly and give me a lot more of that runny look, along with this smoothed out soft paste feel. Oh, let's take a look, see what we're looking at. Oh my. That is going to be gorgeous. All right. I'm going to go wash out my brush again. So I really kind of want to play with this gel matte, but I'm loving the way this looks. So maybe I'll add on these guys. And then if I decide I want to play with the gel matte, I will. So let's start adding them. And I'm just going to use the Fabri-Tac. Actually, it's so empty. It'll take me forever to wait on the darn thing. So I'm going to grab a new bottle here. That way. I think I usually grab the new bottles when I'm filming. That way, you know, the glue comes right out as I need it. And then I'll use my ones that are driving me insane because they're about at the bottom of the barrel. for when I'm not filming. Or I'll merge them with other ones. Know what I mean? All right. Just a light little bit. I don't know, I guess you could use that other, the gel mat or, you know, that other stuff, but I'm so used to using this glue. I'm just going to use it. Sounds good to me, right? I'll put this one, yes, right here. Now this big old one, I kind of want this one right here. So we're going to get this big old one on here. Here we go. And my usual standard, how I glue things together. All crazy like. And I think I will do like the heavy mat as long as it doesn't. I probably have to test it on a section of the printed paper. Make sure it won't make the paper run. I don't remember. Oh, I think that's a white gel mat, not a clear one. But that's okay, because I can just use it to blend the edges of this. There, yeah, I want to move it up a little bit, because we got some blank space up here that it'll feed into nicely. Okay, so we still want to keep this here. So I'm just going to set this here so nothing runs into it. You know, maybe I'll set one of these on top of it or something. Yeah, we'll do this one right there. And the rest of these can, it looks like I may not be able to fit them all, but I can do as many as I possibly can. So we'll do you and you. At this point, I'm just laying them out so I can see what I have. Probably put this one here since it's small enough to fit. And I laid all of these out on my cutting board in the kitchen and whacked them all up pretty good. Oh! Well, would you look at that? They all fit wonderfully. I feel like down here's a little crowded, so I'm gonna move you down and maybe give you a bit more space. Yeah, much better. But I also wanna offset them a little. Perfect. I hope you guys like it as much as I do. I love the coloring and the texture. And this is gonna, so I know you guys, especially if you've been with me for a while, you know about my Little Miss Dasie sign. A gentleman I used to work with in my previous career, he made it for me for my birthday a few years ago. And it was right around the time that I started this journey. And he kind of, you know, started off with his, just barely, you know, doing the woodworking as a side gig, kind of like I do this as a side gig. And he made me this beautiful wooden sign. I mean, magnificent, hand-painted, him and his wife. And it just was phenomenal. And now you guys see it every time you look at my channel art. I now use it as my little watermark at the bottom of my videos. So if you love that work, you definitely, I don't even know if he's still doing it or not. I'm pretty sure he is, though. May not be doing it as much as he was previously, but I know he should still do some of it. His Instagram handle was wooden stuff. He just does magnificent and beautiful work. But anyway, so this canvas will go up next to that, I think. So not only do I have the biggest business logo And of course the motto. I think a lot of people picked up on it a lot before I did. Have a wonderful day. It's not really the motto, but it's just something I say a lot. And of course, when I seen a rubber stamp that said have a wonderful day, I had to buy it after a couple of people, including him painting it on the sign, pointed it out to me. I'm really loving this. And it's just, I think it feels very relaxing just to sit here and glue all these little pieces on and see all your wonderful comments. I mean, I love doing this for you guys. It really makes it worth it knowing that the journals that I create are going to a good and loving home. And that they're going to be cherished for generations and filled with wonderful blessings and wonderful memories. And it's just exciting to know that. Kind of actually gives me chills thinking about it. And I've made quite a few myself, and I need to sit down and journal more. That's actually one of my goals here coming up soon, is to get more junk journal with me videos out. I know that I have some coming, but I haven't gotten a little bit of happy mail in a while. So Monday's kind of like that free video day. So if somebody sends me something, or, you know, if I get anything cool that comes up, that's usually when I'll do it, is on Mondays. And Wednesdays are starting to be my work for me days. And then Fridays are my tutorial days. So I can do beautiful works like this with you guys. And I love the way this canvas is coming out. And all of these wonderful words. It's going to be so pretty. You know, and if you have an Etsy shop, then, you know, do this with yours. Do this with your 5-star reviews. It's a wonderful way to give yourself a little boost. I mean, I've been excited all week anticipating making this project. And that's been one of my goals for the past month or two, is to start working with canvases. So it's going to be pretty exciting to finally hang this on my wall. Because slowly but surely I've been buying up the paint. I've been buying the gesso and the canvases. Because as you guys know, last month or the month before, I did show off some new products of the golden products. And now, of course, we're using them today. And then, of course, I also told you guys that we're going to do a paint pour. And I still have that sitting here. It is on the list. It's on the canvas list. And I know it's a little late past the paint pour craze, but I'm okay with that. I really am. I want to do it to say that I tried it and see how fun it really is. And if I would actually enjoy doing it again. Because if so, then I'll go buy a couple more and do it again. Alright. Now, I have an idea for this one. I'll be back. Okay, guys. So, I got a piece of recycled cardboard here. I'm just going to pick this up and set it aside. And man, I've only walked away for like 2 seconds and the entire canvas is pretty much dry. Of course, it really helps to have gigantic bay windows, and I am literally sweating my booty off right now. And it's mid-October. And I'm, no joke, wearing shorts and pretty much a tank top. So, you know, those of you who are in full winter, get up right now. You're so not fair. Trust me, I know. As of right now, I think I would want some, at least, warm rain going on. You know, something. Alright, we got this smoothed out. Hey, the garbage truck. I convinced Boo to put the garbage out for me last night. He's so sweet. Alright, now I'm going to take this out and cut it up on my board because, you know, it's easier. Okay, I may go ahead and or go in and do this with a hot glue gun later, but I'm on time constraints, so right now I'm just going to do it with these little stickies that I got. My mom, again, got these at a yard sale for me, and I've been playing around with them ever since. So, this is curved outward, and I don't want it to do that. I want it to curve. I think it was from me tearing it up. So, I'm just going to mold it at least to where it sticks. Yeah, there we go. Inward a little bit. And I'm gonna get these little stickies. And I went ahead and backed this specific comment with cardboard because it's gonna be kind of like a floating comment over, oops, over this little guy, this doodad. These things just aren't wanting to cooperate. They're being feisty. Okay. And then one in the middle. For good measure. Alright. Take off all these little thingy-mabobs. And I've only used these a couple of times. I did use them, I think, on a journal previously, which I think that journal comment from the 5-star review is actually in here. And I added hot glue with it on the journal just to make sure that it stayed in place really well. Ooh, all right. But I really, really like the way these look. They're too cute. And they make everything pop up and stick out a little bit. Oops. Next. Well, like always, or like clockwork, the kids decided that they want to play. So, if you hear them over me, I'm sorry. they're so funny. Of course, the other half's kids are here today. He went in to the office early, so the kids came over here. So I got all four of the kids, and now that two of them are roughhousing, the other two will probably join in. All right, gotta move that. Oh my. Alright, I'm not completely finished. I know I have an art pencil. It's usually sitting right here, but it disappeared. So let me find it and I'll come back and finish. Woohoo! So I found my art pencil. I've had this thing for years. So I don't even know if they still make them anymore. But I really specifically like this one. It's always been really good to me. Alright. Okay, this is actually coming up, so I didn't get enough glue on that little corner. Much better. Much, much better. Okay. Well, of course, we want these comments to stand out a little bit, so we're just going to go ahead and outline them. And if you don't know already, this is a little bit of a Mirror Me Small Art thing. I love her work. She does beautiful stuff. Oh, yes. So this is why I love this pencil. Just beautiful. So we're going to do that with the rest of these. Now with the edge of this one, we're just gonna, you know, kind of color. We're not gonna drop it down onto the paper below. I might a little bit over here. Maybe not. We'll keep it up on this piece. And the nice thing about this pencil is it's very shadow friendly, so usually the oils in your fingers will move the colors around really nicely and make it look really great. If you don't want to use your fingers, you can use a shading pencil. That artisan in my family that I told you about actually taught us how to make our own shading pencils as kids, so we had a leg up compared to some. And it's literally just a piece of paper that's as tightly wrapped as you can get it into a pencil. And it works amazing for shading, especially, oh yeah, and see, this is transferring down below anyway. So it's still going to give it that wonderful 3D effect. But that pencil works really, really great for obviously shading and wonderful things like that. So I'm just doing along the bottom of these to kind of give it that pop. Along with that, it gives it like a shadow effect. Makes it a little bit 3D, so they stand out a little bit. That, and when most things have a shadow, and you can kind of use a sundial as a reference. Your shadow only usually goes one way, so you need to pick a direction and stick with it if you want to shadow the whole thing and make it look like the light is hitting it from the front. That is wonderful. Just make sure your shadow doesn't extend too far, because it'll give it like a really extensive popped look. If that's what you're going for, that's perfectly fine. Some of this stuff I did learn in art class and I retained it, which was in high school. I loved art. I really did. It has been so long since I've doodled. A while ago, I was playing around on my tablet and I did post a photo up on my Instagram stories. And I drew a pair of scissors, and it's been a while, but I still did really good. I was surprised that I still had some of my artistic drawing creativity. So I don't like how that... See, I should have just kept it lower on this one. I don't like how it looked right there. Uh-oh, the poopers are barking. They're outside. Because I know the other half is supposed to be home any minute. Because we're going out to my parents' house for a few hours. Yes, just for a few hours. I know it's over 50 miles away. And we're just going for a few hours. Because my mom called me up yesterday. And she's like, there's this big yard sale out here with all of these vintage books. There's like truckloads of vintage books. So I'm sure you guys know where I'm going to be in about 20 minutes. Headed down that way to pick up some vintage books, hopefully. As well, I will be editing this video and another. So I don't want to go all the way up on this one just because it's so big. But I can add some of the shadowing on the outside. And then bring it a little bit more on the inside the further I go down. Again, to add a little bit more texture. And this will kind of give it a slant appearance as well. And it was just, you know, fun to play with. Really expand your skills. And the light's kind of poking in right there. I'm sure you guys are like, I can't see what you're doing there. Sorry if the camera's shaking. All right. See what I mean by direct hit sunlight? I got some lighter curtains so I could use this light to my advantage. And it works wonderful, especially for filming. But again, it can get so warm in here. It's almost like a greenhouse. I want to put plants up, but it's funny because I grew up on a nursery. but I can't keep them alive. And it's not that, you know, I'm not good at keeping plants alive. I know how to do it. I grew up around plants all my life. I know how to keep them alive. I'm just terrible at remembering to water them. It's my biggest fault. I got so much other stuff on my mind that just watering them falls to the back of it. I would like to put some plants in here, though. And maybe, like, I don't know, design an indoor water system, because the sink is, like, right in the other room. So I could probably pull it off, right? But you know how it can be sometimes. Now, because these are more towards the top, and I think these last two, I'm just going to do the bottom to make it look like it's closer to whatever, wherever the light source is coming from. And just keep it down really low up here. And I don't want to do too much coloring, because again, we're keeping our shadows more distinct, but smaller, because it's getting closer to the light source. It's been a while, but I still got some of it rattling around in there. Oh my, I'm really, this is coming out exactly as I had hoped. It is so pretty. So very, very pretty. And here I was worried it was just going to look like a pile of molten paint. I was seriously worried. See, and this, I mean, it's been so long since I've painted. And I think Boo's here. And I never paint on canvas. I mean, this is only the second official canvas I have ever painted on. Yep, Boo is officially here. So I get to finish these last two. And then we will be headed out to the sticks to grab our custom orders. Well, custom orders. Custom supplies. God bless my mom. She's such a wonderful lady. Hi, handsome. I'm finishing up filming. You want to come see what I made? This is my little journal prompt that the life coach wanted me to do. And this is what it, she wanted me to do a journal, and I decided I wanted to do a canvas instead. So this is what I decided to make to inspire me to, you know, keep at it and just keep going. So it's going to get hung over there with the sign that my buddy made me.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty good. All right. Well, I'm about finishing up now, so. All right, guys. Well, I will talk to you later. I am completely in love with this. If I do decide, I may put, like, Lil Miss Dasie along the bottom. But I think I'm going to do it in calligraphy style. Actually, yeah, that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I have a calligraphy set, if those of you that don't know. And I think I'm going to calligraphy it on this, or, like, this, then I'll just tape it down in the corner, or not tape it, glue it down in the corner, and maybe blend it in with the rest of it. So, you know, my name is obviously going to be on it, because that's what this whole thing is supporting, is not only my creativity for you guys, and to be able to make all these beautiful pieces so you can have them in your homes and give me a wonderful boost, but also to say thank you. So I hope you all have a wonderful day. I will talk to you all later. Bye. Thank you.